Hey everybody, we are here at the what we call the VW Rollout in beautiful San Antonio, Texas, and I have the fortune to be talking to Miss Leslie. Leslie, how you doing?
Hi, good.
All right, Leslie, a couple of things. First of all, where are you from?
I'm from Corpus Christi, Texas, born and raised.
Born and raised in Corpus. First of all, thank you for joining us today, and we are standing in front of something pretty darn cool. Can you tell us a little bit what we are standing in front of here?
It's a 1958 single cab. It is going to be a flower business where I will be selling flowers by the stem, and then the customers can approach the vehicle and pick out whatever flowers they desire and then hand them to me, and then around back.
Is that what that board is in the back?
Around back. Okay. I will wrap them up for them and slap a sticker on it, and that's pretty much it, and so they're good to go.
Where are you going to be selling these at? Like, you're just going to drive around randomly and put a stop sign?
All the farmers markets, and any kind of events downtown, all Corpus, Aransas, Rockport.
So everywhere. So where did you get this idea?
So I follow a couple of flower trucks on Instagram years ago. I saw the idea and I wanted to do it, but our truck that we were currently having restored, our double cab, when it was finished, I was like, I don't want to use his truck. So I sold my bug after 16 years.
The famous pink.
The PPD. The panty dropper.
Panty dropper.
Which is now in Tennessee.
It went to Chattanooga, right?
Yes. Yep. So I sold it after 16 years, and then I sold it on a Monday, and on a Wednesday, I bought a single cab. And then I sent my husband to go and get it.
Oh, what a good husband.
On Easter.
You were so lucky. I know. You know that. I always call y'all the Volkswagen power couple.
We've only had it since Easter, and it was just in primer and in pieces.
So when you got it, it was in primer.
Primer and in pieces, and we've gone through it from pretty much, I wouldn't say top to bottom, because we didn't do, you know, all the underneath.
Oh, it's beautiful.
But fully repainted. The canvas, of course, we had that ordered. We did the hoops and the racks.
Right. The system for your flowers, did y'all build that or come up with that?
Yeah, so my husband has a welder friend at work, through his work, and I brought him over one day. He came over and sketched it up on a pad, left, and came back and was like, I got it made, come check it out. And each one of these rings were custom split and welded and made to fit the bucket.
This is so
awesome.
It's
like out of schedule.
So you just kind of said, hey, there's kind of what I want, and then boom.
I showed him a picture of another flower truck on Instagram, and then he was like, oh, okay, I got it. But it was my idea to make it to where they leaned out
at
you.
That's wonderful.
To where they, you know, when they grab the flowers and pull the flowers out, they don't hit the canvas.
Right.
Yeah, so now with their leaned out, it's more like come out at you.
It's wonderful.
Yeah, thank you.
This is your first single cab. You have a camper. Y'all have a Electra, the famous panel. And you had your Beetle. How does it feel driving a single cab, which is like, I mean, it's, you're kind of tighter quarters in it. What do you like? Do you
when
like
when we
it?
Left this morning, it was great. I mean, it just rolled perfectly, and everyone's like, oh my god, it's gonna be so hot in there with just the cab. Man, the wing windows open, it just, I don't know, it was perfect this morning.
You had no problems whatsoever?
No problems whatsoever. No safaris, no rear pop out, nothing. All I have is just the slide windows and the wing windows, and that's it. And it was enough air for me to stay cool.
No problem. Single cabs are really they're the awesome. I love single cabs. When do you think you're gonna, I mean, go live with your selling flowers? We need to tell you have flowers here now, but because I was gonna come over and buy some earlier.
They're not real.
She says they're
for just display only.
So they're only display only.
Yeah.
So when do we go live? I want to buy some flowers.
So I still am working on, well, first of all, I was like, oh, I don't need to worry about any kind of permits. Like, we still have a long time before we finish the truck.
Uh-oh.
Well, then that happened really quick. Like, we did the truck really, really fast. And I'm like, okay, well, I guess now I need to really start working on my permitting and stuff. So sales tax permits, I apply for that. I've started it, I'll finish that up next week. And then I also have to do a floral permit as well to sell at markets and events.
Really?
And stuff. Yeah. So as soon as I get those back from the state, then I plan on going to events and start selling. But so I would say mid-September, fall.
Are you growing the flowers?
No, I'm not growing them.
Okay.
Wholesale in Corpus. Wholesale? Yeah, there's a wholesale place.
Are you just going? So what were you having, like daffodils?
Yeah,
and
just
roses,
all different types. Yeah.
Irises. Yeah. Aren't you impressed that I know?
I know, right? And then greenery, like your fillers and everything.
Baby's so you're
gonna
breath
have,
and all.
Yeah, you're gonna have baby's breath like this.
Oh,
and
yeah.
Then you'll
you'll
have your leaves and like all your filler, you know, to make it bigger.
So they'll pick.
Right. By a stem.
By stem.
Yeah. So right here, the prices are gonna be clipped on them by the stem.
Oh my gosh! Look at that.
Yeah. Little tags will be here.
What a great idea. Yeah.
I mean, that way if they were like, oh, well, I only want to spend $10 or whatever, then they can buy, you know.
You know exactly what
yeah,
you're getting.
Yeah, exactly. They can buy 10 of the $1 stamps.
You're going to be inundated at a show, you know that, or at a market. Uh-huh. People are going to just flood you.
Well, I'm going to sell out quick. Usually, when all the flower trucks that I follow on Instagram and stuff, they post up, we're here until 2 or until we sell out.
Wow.
So I've already gotten a couple people on Instagram saying, how can I rent you? What? When? I've already been bombarded.
For, really? Like for private events?
A wedding coordinator wants me at specifically on December 26th at an event. So
really?
Yeah. And I'm like, I'm not there yet.
Yeah, that's
awesome. So contracts need to be wrote up, all that kind of stuff. So.
That is very cool. Are you excited?
Yes,
I'm excited for you. And I think this.
I like a new adventure.
I know, it's awesome. Yeah. And the single cab is just absolutely stunningly wonderful.
I have to thank Fresno James for selling it to me because he owned it for several years.
That was a fellow in Arizona.
Yes. And I'm sure it really broke his heart to let it go, but he's glad that.
Well, it's gone to a good cause, obviously. Did Mike. Mike Fenton
did the he did all the painting on it.
So let's give a good shout out to him because he I mean this is like
the bed was pretty beat, so we decided to do the rhino liner. It's actually lizard skin, the
lizard
brand.
Skin yes okay.
So and then he color matched it, he painted over the lizard skin, but it's actually really good because if I spill water, any kind of the water is going to be in the bucket.
Yep.
So it's just going to
peel roll right off. It's awesome.
Yeah.
Does it have a name? Just Bentley's?
Its name is Finn. Sven?
Finn?
Sven.
Sven. Yeah. Finn? Sven. Sven? Like a fish?
Sven.
No, it's a German name. It's a boy.
Sven.
Sven? Yeah.
Sven Osven?
Yes.
Oh,
it's a
Sven.
German name. That's what James, Fresno James, named it before. So,
really?
Yeah, I guess.
Sven.
Yeah.
Okay, so S-V-E-N?
S-V-E-N, yes.
Awesome.
Like that. Yeah.
That's cool.
So that's
well, I
thing,
love it. I mean, I love single cabs, and this is going to be a working single cab.
Yes.
This is what they were meant for in the first place.
Yeah.
I'm excited for you guys.
Thank you.
This is
Thank
good.
You. Bentley Flower Truck is already on Facebook and Instagram so
okay.
you can follow each one of
oh,
them.
Oh, yeah. Subscribe and like.
Yeah.
Make sure.
Yeah.
We'll put the link right down here to those so you guys can check it out. So, Leslie, it's wonderful. And I mean, you guys, y'all are the Volkswagen power couple, you and Matt. I mean, y'all
Thanks.
Are. It's just the coolest thing. And y'all being a part of the community, it's always good. So,
we love it. We love
thanks
it.
Thanks for talking to us. This
Thank
afternoon
you.
Here
Thanks.
At the old rollout.
Thanks for interviewing us.
Yay! Thank you.
Thank you.
Hey everybody, Gary back again here at the VW rollout down here at Traders Village, and I am with the one, the only, Mr. Matt Bentley. Ta-da-da-da-da-da! Matt, how you doing, buddy?
Doing good, man. Yourself?
Good to see you tonight, man. We're standing in front of a one sweet double cab. What are we standing in front of here, sir?
This is Sherman. This is my 1965 double cab, painted Turkish.
Oh, one of my my favorite. There's nothing else better
yeah,
than Turkish, man. I love it. Tell me the story. Where did I mean? I've seen and followed this a little bit through the years, but kind of give us a little bit of background. Where did Sherman come from?
Okay, so I guess like 15, 16 years ago, it was back whenever we had the air coolers, the Forum.
Yep.
So I was on there one day and I'm scrolling down and a guy had some stuff for sale and he said, I may sell my 1965 DC. And I said, man, I wonder if that's a double cab. So I hit him up and he said, man, I got two guys that are gonna be here. You know, can you come this weekend? I can be there first thing. So I showed up and boom, I found it Alamo and 6th Street, downtown San Antonio. So
wow.
Yeah, and it was, its nickname was Crustina then. Because dude, it was rusted, you know, from the six inches down, it was gone.
And the name fit perfectly is what you're
saying.
Yeah,
at the time, yeah.
Oh
so.
My gosh. So that was 15 or 16 years ago.
Yeah.
So you got it.
All right, we got
right,
it.
Okay.
And I used it. I used it like a truck.
Well, you drove it.
Yeah,
right, okay.
We took it to the beach
yeah.
and, you know, partied in it.
What it was meant for,
yeah.
right?
And then down the road, I figured I would restore it. And this is what we're looking at now.
And this is it in all its glory.
It is back to the original, the way it should look.
Oh, my gosh.
In my opinion, the way
I
it
agree.
Should look.
It's absolutely perfect. This was done where?
So Ronnie over at Bustorations
in Arizona, right?
Yeah,
okay.
he did all the metal work for me. Amazing guy.
Yes.
Cool cat. He fixed it all up, and I told him I wanted to assemble it. So I think we picked it up 2 years ago at BBB.
Right.
Yeah, and brought it back. And
so it was, he did all the paint.
Yeah, he did all the paint.
Like,
all
were the doors hung to already? And
Yeah, it was just like a dry assembly, pretty much.
Okay.
So you still had to do fit and finish.
And you glass.
Install you had to put all the windows, interior.
So you put everything, but you put it all together.
Yeah, engine, drivetrain, all that stuff. You know, had it been gone through. When we got it back, he didn't paint the underneath, so I took it over to Thomas's house, man, and we put it on a rotisserie, rolled it on its side, painted underneath, and then I was like,
So it was already painted in your
garage? It was painted, and then I went ahead and repainted underneath of it.
That had to be a little sketchy. Were you a little scared?
It was. I had like all the guys over, and I was like, hey, man, we're going to roll this thing on its side. And I was like, go slow, go slow.
kind of slow. Yeah. Holy cow, really?
So we did
all
that.
I did not know that.
And then, you know, it was supposed to be a mild restoration, and then it's turned into this.
Wonderful is what it is.
Yeah.
So let's tell, what are we running drivetrain-wise?
I'm running a 63 one-ton small axle transmission in it.
Yep.
We've got the 2110 dual carbs, A1 stainless exhaust, polished.
And you can see right now, too, I mean, this you're pulling a pretty good-sized little travel trailer here. What's the story on that hitch?
I needed a hitch that would stand up to the weight of this.
Yes.
So we ended up having to custom make that hitch to fit, but it pulls
no problems at all. No problems at all. I mean, it's just unbelievable. Before we go any further, tell me a little bit about the hoop and the tilt here. I mean, are this stuff you just don't find all that
it is
anywhere.
You can find it on Samba. Tom did the canvas,
right?
So,
and Tom's up in like in the north somewhere,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, Maine.
Maine, okay.
It's amazing.
It really is.
It fits great.
The fit and finish is perfect.
Real watertight. So
it is really watertight.
And this truck actually came factory on the M code. It originally came with the tilt and canvas. So I was like, it has to go back on it.
Yeah, it did.
So.
Wow. Interior wise, what do we got going on in here?
Original style.
Yep.
But just updated, more clean looking.
Right.
I like the way it looks.
I like the wheel.
Wow.
The steering wheel is really awesome.
The barn door era style wheel for it.
Very nice touch there. And the seats, very good. I mean, it's just so clean. It's just the way I love it. It's got a perfect style. It's perfect style. And you're running big meats too.
Oh yeah. Disc brakes on the front.
Okay, what kit, do you know what kit that is on those?
I got them from Ronnie.
Okay.
So it's a kit that he makes.
Really?
It's kind of a custom setup that he's got. One of the cool things we did was, I wanted a stereo system in it.
Right.
But I wanted it hidden. So what we did was, we put speakers behind
In the stand back there?
Yeah. So we took the louvers off the back and then, you know, grafted them in here and then put the speakers behind it. So everything's kind of hidden.
Oh my gosh.
So, like a clean setup.
That is awesome. Double cabs have a very unique look, you know? I just think they're just awesome. All together, just fantastic. Everything is just so clean, buddy. It's great.
Yeah, we put a lot of work into getting everything done on it and making it look presentable, because I was originally just going to make this thing a driver, and then it's turned into this.
It's turned into something amazing.
Like, the headlights are just a nightmare to try to find a nice set of headlights for it. And I ended up, the only nice pair I could find were an NOS pair that's been in the box for, you know, for 40, 50
Holy
years.
Cow. Really?
Yeah, that's why they're so clean.
Those are NOS fluted lens.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't want to even know I don't even want to know where you gave those. I think your choice of going with the gray on the bumper.
That's all Leslie.
Is it really?
She picked the whole color scheme, because I was just going to go with standard white. And she's like, no, we're going gray. I'm telling you right now.
it's a good look. Really, I think.
And then with the canvas being that color, I think it turned out good.
And the emblem, that's a nice touch. It really is. It's a very nice touch.
Thanks, man.
Well, man, as always, Matt, it's always good visiting with you, buddy.
I mean,
I appreciate your time. What you've done to it and how far it's gone, I like the fact that you've had it so long. It was just...
It's a keeper. It ain't going anywhere.
It ain't going nowhere.
It ain't going nowhere. Not for sale.
But at one point, it was like, you were just rusty and you drove it, and then you're like, okay.
Yeah.
You just decided one day, it's like, you know what, I'm going to...
You spilled a drink in it, it didn't matter. If it got bumped into, it didn't matter. And then now it's like, I'll fight you.
Exactly. Matt, thank you, brother, as always, man.
Yeah, right on.
I appreciate it. You're awesome. Yeah. Thanks, man.
These guys are the coolest, man.